You know how it's supposed to go.
Only the elected knows it.
Amen.
And Philip saw it. He couldn't stand it any longer. He knew that was Messiah. So he went to a fellow that had Bible study together. Nathaniel, he said, come see the man. Come see what we found. Amen. We have found Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
We found Jesus of Nazareth. That's the prophet that Moses spoke of to become. Amen. We found him. We found him. He said, how can it be? Where was he? See, he wasn't he didn't know the rhythm just exactly. They'd been studying. But when he got there, he told him, introduced to him the word. And when he got there, Jesus said, behold an Israelite. The rhythm began to take hold.
Amen.
The great drama was being played out there on the platform or on the ground that day. Maybe Jesus standing up on a rock talking to the people. And when Philip come up with Nathanael, he looked over to him and said, behold an Israelite in whom there's no guile. He said, Rabbi, when did you ever know me? He said, before Philip called you, when you were under the tree, I saw you. Oh, my. He was part of it.
Amen.
He said, thou art the Son of God. Thou art the King of Israel. No matter what the world beats was and all their shindigs they had of the denominations, it wasn't that great sympathy of God.
Amen.
He said, thou art that King of Israel. There you are. I see it. I know it. Why, he was elected. The elected seed knows it. Always, through every age. That they know it. Say, but Brother Branham, what about my mother and dad? What about my people? What about my denomination? Well, what will they do? They'll cast me out. Is it? If you can't look ahead, look up.
Amen.
Don't try to look ahead anyhow. Put your hand in his.
Amen.
Let him lead you.
Amen.
Look up. Don't look ahead. You say, while others make fun of me about my long hair and me taking off shorts and about me leaving the church, suffering for his name's sake is growing pains of his grace. Yeah. Suffering for his word, see, is growing pains of his grace. Yes, sir. Just remember, it's the grace of God's been given to you. Oh, my. Like Paul said, hallelujah. He had an infirmity. Something has bothered him. The devil had buffeted him, blow after blow. And he consulted the Lord 3 times to take it away from him. He said, I don't want this, Lord. Take it away from him. And then one night the Lord spoke to him and said, Saul, or Paul, my grace is sufficient. He said, then I'll glory in my infirmity.
Amen.
I'll glory in it. I know you're the healer. I've seen you heal the sick, raise the dead, and cast out devils,
amen,
open the eyes of the blind. But if I've consulted you and you tell me it's your grace is sufficient, then this devil that bothers me is the growing pains of your grace. Then I'll glory in my infirmities. Why? If, lest I get exalted above the abundance of the revelation.
Amen.
See, he had something the other disciples didn't have. He saw him after his death, burial, resurrection, ascension. He saw him.
Yes.
Some of them say, well, I walked with him. So did everybody on the street.
Yes.
But after he's dead, buried, rose, and ascended up and returned back in the form of a pillar of fire, he talked to Paul.
Yes.
That more than any of the rest of them had.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. He said, except I get exalted and want to build great big seminaries and everything else and great big something and other, lest I get exalted above the abundance of this revelation, God let a messenger of the devil keep me beat down. He said, then when I'm weak, I'm strong.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Growing pains of grace.
Amen.
Amen. We could stay on that a long time. An hour and 45 minutes has passed.